Good afternoon, everybody. So, Sirish was asking me, what is matrix reimprinting? So, today's topic is sort stress with matrix reimprinting. It's not any kind of printing. It doesn't mean I'm going to start a printing press. It means that we are going to re-look at our life, reprint the part of our life that was traumatic. So, all of us go through various traumatic experiences in our life, but we don't know how to change those. So, the memory remains fixed. So, if I went through financial losses, then and it happened and it didn't, it's not happening now, but the way I perceive is that as if it's happening now. Some child got abused like I was at the age of 6, but every time the abuse topic comes up, you go back to the same room, you go back to the same circumstances and sorry, I apologize for that. But nobody knows how to change that part of it. I mean, ask somebody to change for me at 6 years of age, what was happening in that room, it's very difficult for me. And it would have remained, and I would have remained confided in that room forever, had I not worked on myself. People have traumatic marriages. And the trauma that they give each other in that marriage, each one underestimates themselves and thinks that they were right and the other person is at wrong. Reality is, in any partnership, whether it was marriage, a business partnership or any kind of partnership, there are always, and if it is not working, there are always two people who were not correct. Which means from their point of view, they were right. They stood by what they thought was correct, but they did not stand by a partnership. They did not play the rules of negotiation in a partnership. A partnership is all about give and take. But like I said, those things happened back in time. They are not happening right now. But how do we perceive life, even if it happened 40 years back, 30 years back, 20 years back, 2 days back, we look at it as if it's happening now. The minute we think about it, we bring back in our field all the emotions, all the trauma and all the feelings that we had at the time of the accident. And our body can actually go through trembling and reactions, which are similar to the time when our trauma started. So, whether it happened 10 days ago or it happened 40 days back or it happened 40 years back, nothing changes for you because you have not let go. And despite all the talks of let go, you didn't know how to go and tweak it, you didn't know how to re-imprint it back. It's like the editing. If on the computer, and thank God for all the technology, I really acknowledge all the scientists who've done the technology today created, where I remember during my college time when I had to write a thesis on textile chemistry, which is what I used to be teaching at Nirmal Niketan College of Home Science. But before that, I was a student there and had to write a thesis, and I was writing a thesis on pilling of cloth. Now, can you imagine pilling of cloth and writing a thesis, and we didn't even have a computer at that time. It was unheard of. And I remember still there was a little place next to my house which is called like a cow gully, where there were all these computer guys sitting, and I would sit with them and we were busy typing. And any mistake meant the whole paper roll would go like this into the dustbin. Then he would retype it again. And I still remember my HOD, head of the department, being very angry with me because there was someone else who had done computer printing. and computer printing at that time was 50 bucks a sheet, and I couldn't afford it. So I couldn't get that done for her, though I went to become a staff in that college. But really interestingly, she was quite mad with me because there were few spelling mistakes and error. Today's technology, the minute you write on the computer, they show you error, error, red, grammarly is there. They will show you all these markers are there, and as an opportunity for you to then relook at it. And what do you do then? You go and you recheck it, you sort out all the things, you look at the grammar, you look at the spelling, and you put the document back again. Why am I talking about this? Because that's exactly what I want to teach you how to do with your life. So you had a trauma, there were red marks there, the grammar of the trauma wasn't okay, the spellings weren't okay, and it is not my HOD who is looking at your thesis and saying, not good enough. But it's you who is looking at the thesis of your own. You are doing PhD in your own life and you are looking back at it, and all this typing has now happened on a handwritten typewriter where you do not know what to do about it. So you have to retype the whole thing again, and that retyping is called the reprinting. I hope that's very, very clear. Let's take now the real officially understanding who created it. He's my teacher, Carl Dawson, and I am officially the master trainer of Matrix Reimprinting in India. I think I'm the only one right now who is doing this. Yes. Ranganath Chaudhary was another one who used to be working with Carl Dawson at one point. I don't know whether she's still doing it or not. So I teach this modality along with being Matrix Reimprinting master trainer. I'm also the master trainer for Mehta Health, which I've been constantly talking about. So today a little shift from Mehta Health, but we will combine Mehta Health anyway, because both these modalities came to me together. So he is my teacher. I met him many, many years back in Prague, and I am very, very grateful to this man. He changed my life. I am standing here today in front of you because of this man. He is somebody who's so humble, so beautiful. I remember going from India to learn Matrix Reimprinting, and he actually driving 2 hours to come and pick me up. I didn't think that was normal. I thought that was amazing actually, because I probably have very low self-worth of myself and had very, very low self-worth at that point. And to see him coming and picking me up, I was completely humbled. Not only did he do that, but he made sure that I had the right residence to live in. He made sure, because I was coming from India, he didn't know whether I knew about the Tesco's and how to buy the food. He said, he stopped the car and said, go bring whatever you need to. But that's who he is. He was one day working with a client and doing traditional EFT, which we'll be talking about. And the lady said, I can see myself. So he said, what do you mean you can see yourself? She said, well, I can see myself at 6 years of age. So he said, okay, why don't you go and tap on yourself at 6 years of age? And she said, okay. And she tapped on her six-year-old. So in her imagination, she could see her six-year-old, and Carl asked her to go and tap on her six-year-old, which she did, and the trauma vanished. Trauma vanished faster than he had ever experienced trauma vanishing. He said, there's something here that I haven't used before. Since he's thinking like this, there's something over here that I haven't used before. So he started experimenting with it. And from that experience was born Matrix Reimprinting. So one person went ahead and tapped on herself in a memory, and a whole modality. I think today there are more than 3,000 practitioners across the world. And I don't know how many trainers, my numbers may be all wrong, but the lot of modalities which have got integrated, like, you know, you have matrix reimprinting for pain, matrix reimprinting for past life, matrix reimprinting for trauma, it can be used for various different parts of your life. Matrix reimprinting for money, birth reimprinting, so there are various different names and modalities under it. Subdivision. So the basic therapy is the same, but each therapist had their own flavor and then they developed it further. He also has two books to his which are written by, one of them is written I think by Sasha Ellenby, and I don't know about the second one who's written it, but it's on matrix reimprinting. You can actually go on the Amazon and pick it up. Hay House publication is there and it is on matrix reimprinting. They are the books LMB has written for him, but yeah, but it is under his name, Carl Dawson and Matrix Reimprinting. There are probably two books around, a must buy. So that's about Carl Dawson. So he is one of the 27th master under the main guy who actually created EFT. We'll be talking about him a little later. And what's really interesting is Gary Gregg today talks about EFT in a very different way. When it all started, it was very, very different. I think everybody needs to know a little bit of history, which is why I've given you this history. That's me and Carl Dawson. This is last year. I got my certification again, which you have to re-get your certificates after a few years. So I had to repeat the whole class with him last year in Jan, and I was one of the again recertified trainers across the world. Yeah. So how did it help me, and why am I talking about matrix reimprinting to you? Like I've mentioned before, at 6 years of age, I was abused by my uncle, who was old enough to be my grandfather. And it all happened number of times, but one scene that really couldn't get out of my head is the what his sister worked with me last year, Caroline Dawson, and she was able to get me out of that scene. So it's been 9 years of long work, and sometimes even 9 years aren't enough to deal with something like that. So the first time my memory came back in 2008, it was his first class of matrix reimprinting in Praha, where he met me and he started working on 6-year-old Anu, and 6-year-old Anu wanted to kill. And I'm telling him, I'll slap you. And I was actually telling him I will slap you. I wasn't telling the abuser. But he wasn't listening. So Martha, the lady who had introduced me to him, and he had a bet on that day saying Anu is actually wanting to hit the abuser, and Carl Dawson is saying that to Martha, and Martha said, no, I know Anu too well, she wants to hit you. Next day when I walked in, there was a lot of tears and screaming and shouting Monday before. Deep regards for him, because he recorded the session like this and never put it up. Never put it up. It was too traumatic. He next day asked me, were you wanting to hit me or the abuser? And I said, you. How dare you touch me without asking my permission? So remember, it was an abuse case. And in matrix reimprinting, you hold the person like this. You hold the person's hand like this. And you tap on the person. And it wasn't okay with me.
Because you were in that
memory. I was in that memory. And I'm telling him, leave me, I will hit you. And Carl Dawson kept thinking I'm talking about the abuser. I was actually talking about him. So anyway, just to let you know, he helped me to deal with the trauma that, and to actually, I didn't have any memory before this happened. It was on that day that I revived my memory, and my whole life changed after that. I confronted my mom, I confronted people, I became who I am because then I stood loudly and spoke about abuse. We worked in sexual abuse with a lot of children, came back to India, too many things rolled in. And then the part of the memory kept coming back in slow pieces and bits because I didn't remember everything. Last year, there were two people who worked on me. One was Caroline, and one was the lady who was helping out over there. She worked on me, and beautifully, I was able to release myself from that room where I felt imprisoned. So deep regard to him, and if that can happen in your life, can you imagine what happens? So what is emotional freedom technique? Let's all experience it for 2 minutes. So emotional freedom technique is an alternative treatment for physical pain or emotional distress. It is also referred to as tapping or psychological acupressure. People who use this technique believe tapping the body can create a balance in your energy system and can treat pain. Now let's experience it. Just by saying something like that, nothing comes alive. So let's understand what are the tapping points. Are all the tapping points going to be used in matrix reimprinting? Not all of them. We'll be tapping around today just for you to first experience how EFT helps the body. Okay, so I want you all to have a deep breath. Take a deep breath, please. My breathing right now is not very deep. It's not reaching till the navel, as they call it. And it's reaching probably till here, which is how we all of us generally breathe, which is very shallow. And my breathing right now would be around 5 or 6 out of 10. So just calculate how much your breathing is. Would you know, Sheetal, how much would your breathing be right now? 5. How much would yours? 12. 7. Yours? 8.
You mean number of minutes?
No, I mean to say, if, thank you for asking that question. 0 means I can't breathe at all, I'm dead. I'm hoping all of us are alive here. And 10 means I can breathe with ease. So 10 means I'm breathing with ease. It's perfect. It can't be better than that. So when you're breathing, I'm not feeling as if my breath is very great, so I'm feeling I'm breathing mediocre. So I'm breathing around 5 or 6. So you calculate how much do you think you're breathing from 0 to 10. In the spectrum of 0 to 10, where is your breath right now? Can you take that? How much is it?
5.
Very good.
Mine is 9.
9. How much is yours? 7. So we've all got our numbers. So when I'm saying my number, you're supposed to say your number. Okay, so we start first with the tapping point. This is the karate chop point. Is it karate chop point? Even though my breathing is at 5, I can give myself permission to breathe better. We'll do it 3 times here. Even though my breathing is at 5, I can allow myself to breathe better. Even though my breathing is at 5, I can allow myself to breathe better. The next spot is here, okay? Now I want you to be very delicate with it. It's like a butterfly kiss, like really delicate. Like really how you touch baby skin, you don't hit very harshly like that. Even though my breathing is at 5, I can give myself permission to breathe better. Perfect. Right in the middle over here. Even though my breathing is at 5, I can allow myself to breathe better. Superb. Side of the eye. Even though my breathing is at 5, I can allow myself to breathe better. You should minimum tap 7 times on each point. That's a minimum, okay? Under the eye, this is very good point for the stomach. People who've got a lot of gastric problem, this is super point to tap on. Even though my breathing is at 5. I can allow myself to breathe better. Superb. Under the nose, even though my breathing is at 5. I can allow myself to breathe better. Under here in the chin area, even though my breathing is at 5. I can allow myself to breathe better. As you're tapping, you will find belching, burping, sleepiness coming in. It's all part of the process. Right over here on the collarbone, even though my, you can see the collarbone, and under the collarbone there is this area, a little thick area there, yes. Even though my breathing is at 5, I can allow myself to breathe better. My breathing is at 5. I can allow myself to breathe better. This is a like a monkey scratching point. Even though my breathing is at 5, I can allow myself to breathe better. This is very good point for the spleen, for your blood circulation. Very good. Next we come to the hand. Each finger, right sides, even though my breathing is at 5, I can allow myself to breathe better. My breathing is at 5. I can allow myself to breathe better. I'm breathing at 5. I can allow myself to breathe better. My breathing is at 5. I can allow myself to breathe better. My breathing is at 5. I can allow myself to breathe better. My breathing is at 5. I can allow myself to breathe better. There's a point here which joins all the fingers, right here. My breathing is at 5. I can allow myself to breathe better. My breathing is at 5. I can allow myself to breathe better. Just see if you're breathing better. Yes? You can feel the ease, and we just tapped for how long? Hardly 1 minute, right? So I just want you to see this, that 1 minute of tapping can help you to breathe better, and all the gurus will tell you, if you can breathe properly, your health is fine. You're yawning, you're feeling sleepy, a lot of gas discharge. All this is the toxins that you're storing in your body. Your body's gone from stress, sympathetic into parasympathetic. So now that you've got the points, let's do it once more. Now that your breathing has become better, so my breathing has now become 8, actually from 5. So we're going to do one more tapping round, and then I'll give you one more point, which is called cementing the change kind of. It's the gamut point on which we'll be working, okay? So let's start again. Even though my breathing has become better, like 8, how much ever is yours, please use your number, okay? Even though my breathing has become better, I can allow myself to breathe even more better. I can give myself permission to breathe better than 8. I want to be able to breathe better than 8. I give myself permission to breathe better than 8. It's okay for me to breathe better than 8. It's okay for me to breathe better than 8. I give myself permission to breathe better than 8. I give myself permission to breathe better than 8. Very good. I give myself permission to breathe better than 8. Give myself permission to breathe better than 8. I give myself permission to breathe better than 8. I give myself permission to breathe better than 8. I am allowed to breathe better than 8 because I'm worth it. I give myself permission to breathe better than 8 because I love myself. Yeah, I give myself permission to breathe better than 8 because I'm beautiful. I give myself permission to breathe better than 8 because I deserve it. Very good. Take a deep breath and see whether your breath is even better. It actually is for me. Yeah. So now we are going to be tapping at this point. It's called. Yes. Before you do variations, do this. Yeah. And even if you didn't, we'll be doing a lot of work right now. First, just in between these two fingers, you'll be tapping here. It's called the 9 gamut point. Look on the one side, look on the other side, move your eyes round, move your eyes clockwise, then anticlockwise or clockwise, anticlockwise, then clockwise, it doesn't matter, it's like making an lazy eight. Now we're going to sing a song. Happy birthday to you, happy birthday to you. And we're going to say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, so let's just stop here and see what was I doing. One is the left side of your brain, one is the right side of your brain. I was actually, what they use in the brain gym, they use this lazy 8 to balance the brain of the children. I'm making you do this lazy 8 with your eyes. So try this once again. Tap over here, look on one side, look the other side, move your eyes clockwise, move your eyes anti-clockwise. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. What are we doing? We are balancing the two sides of the brain. Why is that important? We are constantly either using the left side of the brain, which is for logic, or we're using the right side of the brain, which is for creativeness. If I have to balance your brain, I have to bring in this whole ritual so that your brain starts processing and doesn't just work from one side. It's beneficial if you can operate from both the sides of your brain, which very few people do. Over a period of time, we make people either creative or put them in a box of being logical. And it doesn't work in the long run. Because when we were born, we had both the sides open up for us. So that's part of the process. So I've just given you points. We did a little demonstration. This was conventional EFT.
I have one question.
Yes.
Is there this breathing wave, is it different from heartbeat rate? Because when the breathing wave is increased, then our heartbeat rate is also increased or not?
Sir, can we ask all these questions at the end? It's different. It's different. Your breathing rate, your heart rate is all different, but breathing will impact your heart. It will impact the heart. I'm going to be showing you the slide anyway.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yes. When our heart rate will increase.
I'm going to be discussing it, sir. So this is a gentleman, Gary Craig, who created EFT, and he is an engineer by profession, who was able to take a big technique which had I don't know how many points and convert them into 13 or 14 points, which became user friendly, and we were not using needles. You were using the tapping on the points where otherwise the needles would have been used. Needles are used even today. In fact, I attended a workshop yesterday where the man was doing acupuncture.
Yes, they
use the needles, and these are the meridian points. These are all main meridian points on which we are tapping. So how interesting is it if you don't have to go to a specialist, you can sit at home. Work on these points that I've shown you, and they actually open up the governing meridians or nadis, as you call it, and beautifully as nadis, as you call it. Nadis word came from nadi. Nadi means river. So the rivers inside us are the channels inside us which otherwise are called the meridians, and you could open these meridians or these nadis or nadis inside you, the rivers inside you, with just this tapping. And that was created by this amazing man. So I met him about 3 years back in a convention, where today he says that you can even tap without touching the person. Yes, you can look at the person and imagine that you are tapping on that person. And the work gets done. And he showed it to us and the work actually gets done. So your intention is very, very powerful. Where your mind takes you, where you put your energy, you will get the results there. Okay? I just thought that was worth mentioning, that he's also moved in his life. He calls it energetic EFT. So this is a person, his name is Max Planck. He is the father of quantum theory, and he shocked the world by saying that there is a matrix of energy that provides the blueprint to our physical world. Which means, kal kya hoga, instead of looking at that song, kal kya hoga kisko pata, actually pata hai universe ko ki kal kya hoga. It's suspended. Imagine if we were all sitting in a jelly. आपने जेली खाई है? अगर उस जेली के अंदर छोटे छोटे हम पार्टिकल्स की तरह सस्पेंडेड हैं, मतलब हम यूनिवर्स के अंदर इसी तरीके से एक मैट्रिक्स के अंदर वी आर सस्पेंडेड, और हमारा दिमाग क्या सोच रहा है, वो दिमाग क्या कह रहा है, उसकी सोच उस जेली के अंदर सस्पेंडेड है. Yes. So can you imagine, aap yahan baithe hain, Sirish is thinking something, Sheetal is thinking something, Shyam is thinking something, Sarji is thinking something, Lord, and all are thinking and all thoughts are coming like this. These thoughts do not remain inside your head, unlike what you believe. Agar aap ek hi cheez ko bar 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 apni zindagi mein dohra rahe ho, it creates a blueprint, and that blueprint will create the reality tomorrow. Like, I still remember standing at Juhu Beach at the age of 13. I distinctly remember this. My cousin, brother and sister are standing there, and there was a tap on the side which we opened to drink water. And we all laughed, ki ek time aayega, pani will become so precious that they will put it in the bottle and they will say, ye le lo. Today it is the reality. आपने एक बार सोचा होगा कितना मजा आएगा अगर हर इंसान के पास एक फोन होता, और आज ये reality है. So your thoughts don't remain just sitting where you are. Every thought of yours has a potential property of making it into reality, whether a bad reality or a good reality. So and that was found by Max Planck many years back, where you couldn't even, maybe you were not even born at that time. He had the mindset of saying, you know what, we are all suspended in a field. And he is actually called the quantum theory, the quantum physics as you call it. He's the father of it, okay. So the matrix is another name given for what quantum physicists call the quantum field, which others have called the field, the mind of God, nature's mind, the divine matrix. Same thing, but different names. It's like aloo ko kisi ne aloo bulaya, kisi ne brambori bola, kisi ne batata bola, but baat wahi hai. Okay? In this place of pure energy, everything begins, from the birth of the stars and the DNA, to our deepest relationships, peace between nations, to our personal healing. Everything is in this jelly. Has everybody understood when I say jelly what it means? Imagine karo, ye pura room universe hai, this whole room is a universe. You all are different particles in this universe. But you think you have no impact on this world.
It is connected.
We are all connected. Whether we like it or we don't like it, we are all connected. And what is happening in our head has deep impact on what is going to happen to that man on the street. Forget the man on the street. What you are thinking may have an impact on a girl who is going to be born tomorrow. Yes, I mean, imagine this room may, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 men, 2 women, these 6 men, 3 women, I forgot myself. So, 3 women, and we are all thinking, and let's say right now, we are thinking about a baby child, we are talking about the baby child. And how a baby child should be taken care of, how she should be nurtured, how a boy child and baby child should both be at the same place, a girl child and the boy child. Will our thoughts have an impact on a child who is not born? How you think is going to impact and let it remain suspended in the whole place. Now imagine this is the place of pure energy, where everything is starting from shunya, place of nothingness. Like very beautifully yesterday, one of my teachers said to me, either we expand energy and then expand it so much like a balloon, you keep adding the gas to it, the air inside it, till you expand it so much that it bursts and it goes into nothing. Yeah. I contract your energy so much that it goes to zero. Either way, from shunya starts everything. And this place of pure energy has that shunya suspended in it. From where everything has begun, your birth, stars ka birth, DNA, including hamare relationships, hamari peace kaise hoga nations ke beech mein. Or hamari personal healing pe. Matlab kal, don't we hear it so often, yaar? Everybody seems to be getting cancer today. Every third person you hear, they have got cancer. Ye cancer badh gaya hai ke diagnostic tools badh gaye hai. So how our life is going to be also geared is not just dependent on you. It is dependent on everyone else. Isliye aap ek insaan ki mind ki safai karoge na, तो उसका इंपैक्ट बाहर तक जाएगा. इमेजिन देयर इज अ फील्ड ऑफ एनर्जी दैट कनेक्ट्स एवरीथिंग. एवरीथिंग मींस एवरीथिंग इन दिस वर्ल्ड. वी आर ऑल कनेक्टेड. दैट इज रियलिटी. आवर एनर्जी इज इन कांस्टेंट फ्लो थ्रू एंड बिटवीन ऑल ऑफ अस एंड एवरीथिंग एल्स इन द यूनिवर्स. So you think you are not.
This is the base of distant healing.
This is the base of all kinds of healing. And not just healing, this is the basis of birth of anything. That's why I'm taking little time to explain to you. Aapko lagta hai ki aap soch rahe ho aur uska koi farak nahi padega. Par aapke dimag mein jo chal raha hai, agar ek insaan ko cancer ho raha hai, dusre ko bhi ho raha hai, tisre ko bhi ho raha hai, the probability of you getting it is how high? Because the energetic fields are all disturbed. Aise ek puja kar raha hai, dusra puja kar raha hai, tisra kar raha hai, fourth one is also doing prayers, fifth one, sixth one, aap compel hoge, wahan pe pull hoge, usi story mein. So, it begins with one story. Aap kisi bhi business ko dekh lo, shunya se shuru hota hai. And then it becomes a multi. The field plays the role of a container and mirror of our beliefs. Everything is connected. So beliefs kya hue? What are beliefs, guys?
Deep embedded conditioning. Be lying.
Okay, so you are lying to yourself. And you are calling it a fact. and you are living your life like this. If I spell it the other way around, it will become life. You are being in life in a way that you are lying constantly, and you are calling all these lies facts, and S stands for your surface. Surface stands for your boundary. Yes, that's why जो आपको जो सोच आपको बांध दे, जो सोच आपको आगे बढ़ने ना दे, वो सोच आपकी सिर्फ झूठ है, वो सच हो ही नहीं सकती है. और वो सच को आप अपनी जिंदगी बना बैठे हैं और वहां से उसे फैक्ट बना बैठे हैं, हकीकत बना बैठे हैं, और उसे आप कह रहे हैं कि बस इसके अलावा मैं और सोच ही नहीं सकता. ये जो सोच है ये हमारे फील्ड के अंदर इकट्ठी करी हुई है और इस सोच को आप लेके जी रहे हैं. फील्ड इज होलोग्राफिक, एवरी पार्ट इज कनेक्टेड विद एवरी अदर. सब कुछ सब चीज के साथ, पौधों के साथ, एक छोटी सी वहां बिल्डिंग आती है, इट्स गोइंग टू हैव एन इम्पैक्ट ऑन यू. अगर साथ वाली बीवी की पिटाई हो रही है तो इट इज गोइंग टू हैव एन इम्पैक्ट ऑन यू. वी आर कनेक्टेड टू यूनिफाइड इन अ यूनिफाइड फील्ड and ultimately our survival as species may be directly linked to our understanding of unified quantum field view. So Greg Brandon, he spoke about fields, and you must go on the YouTube and watch his YouTube. I will not be presenting YouTubes over here, but I will give you the gist of what he says. He says hum yahan khade hain na to hamara dil yahan hai, लेकिन हमारे दिल का जो फील्ड है वो सिर्फ इस कमरे में नहीं है, ये थ्रू आउट द यूनिवर्स है. जो मेरा दिल का असर सामने वाले के दिल पे असर हो सकता है, मतलब इट्स लाइक जो मेरे साथ यहाँ हो रहा है वो पूरे बॉम्बे के ऊपर असर हो सकता है. एक लड़की, अगर एक कोई भी इंसान, आपने मलाइला के बारे में सुना है? At the time when Taliban was talking and they said कि अगर कोई भी मुंह खोलेगा तो उसको हम मार देंगे, उसके फादर के पास बीबीसी वाले आए और बोले एक बच्ची को तो बोलिए कि हमारे बारे में क्या यहाँ चल रहा है वो बताए. तो the father of that Advan girl got up and she said I will speak, but what happened was that the father of that girl came and said my daughter will not talk anything on BBC. This is the time when Malala's father went and gave her the notebook and said write beta, write what is happening over here in the captivity. And she started talking and she started giving briefings at a very young age. She started giving briefings aur jo usne us time kiya, it has impacted a girl child to study more. सो अगर आपको लगता है कि आपकी आवाज़ छोटी है, आपके पास जॉब नहीं होगा तो आपके पास कुछ नहीं है करने के लिए, आप हमेशा यूजफुल हैं और हमेशा यूजफुल रहेंगे. योर फील्ड हैज़ एन इम्पैक्ट ऑन द मदर अर्थ, हैज़ एन इम्पैक्ट ऑन एवरी पर्सन ऑन दिस अर्थ. सो बी वेरी केयरफुल एंड बी वेरी अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ इट. Subconscious programs हमारे 95 to 98% of our daily behavior में काम करते हैं. Please watch Bruce Lipton and what he talks about subconscious programmings. वो कहते हैं कि हम honeymoon effect में सिर्फ जब we are falling in love हम रहते हैं, बाकी time we are in subconscious programs. मतलब कहने का ये है, जब आपको इश्क होता है, वो इश्क वाला लव होता है, तो उस समय यू लव मीटिंग द पर्सन, वो एक हंसी स्माइल आपके चेहरे पे खुद ही आता है. आप उसको मिलते हो ना तो आपके अंदर ऑक्सीटोसिन, सेरोटोनिन, डोपामाइन सब फ्री ऑफ चार्ज मिलता है आपको, ठीक है. एंटी डिप्रेसेंट्स में भी सेरोटोनिन रहता है. अक्सर उस समय आपको लगता है आपकी जिंदगी बहुत हसीन है, बहुत प्यारी है. रेस्ट ऑफ द टाइम आपको ऐसी जिंदगी नहीं लगती है, क्योंकि द रेस्ट ऑफ द टाइम आप इश्क में नहीं होते हो, not with yourself, not with anyone, not with anything. तो 90-95% of the time हम अपनी सोच में ही उलझे रहते हैं. अभी भी मैं जब आपसे बात कर रही हूँ तो आपके सिर में आप अपने आप से बात कर रहे हैं, और आप किससे बात कर रहे हैं अपने सिर में? आप अपने सबकॉन्शियस प्रोग्रामिंग से बात कर रहे हैं. आप अपने एक्सपीरियंस को पीछे हटा के वहां जाके देख रहे हैं, चेकमेट कर रहे हैं, अच्छा ये मिलता है, अच्छा ये मेरे को फिट होता है, ये नहीं फिट हो रहा, ये चीज मुझे समझ में आ गई, ये नहीं आई. Many of these negative programs are imprinted in the first 6 years of your life based on traumas, misconceptions and observing those around you. मतलब ये पहले 6 साल आपकी जिंदगी के, स्पेशली आपका बर्थ, बहुत 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 इम्पोर्टेंट है. नेगेटिव सेल्फ वर्ल्ड व्यूज आर डेवलप्ड इन विट्रो एट बर्थ इन द फर्स्ट 6 years ऑफ लाइफ often through traumatic experiences. Yes, I will just explain to you. Imprinting refers to the system by which humans take on characteristics of their parents by observation and imitation. So, can I borrow one person? Anybody who is ready to come here? Aap aajoge Sheetal? Aajoge. So, let's work with Sheetal a little bit. देख रहे हैं कि ट्रॉमास कैन बी इन विट्रो ऑल्सो, ट्रॉमास कैन बी आउटसाइड ऑल्सो. सो यू हैव एनी आइडिया अबाउट योर बर्थ, हाउ यू वर बॉर्न, वेदर यू हैड अ नॉर्मल डिलीवरी? श्योर, ओके. एंड इनसाइड द मदर्स वोम, डिड मॉम हैव अ लॉन्ग डिलीवरी, शॉर्ट डिलीवरी, व्हाट वॉज इट लाइक? वेरी गुड. दिस आई वॉन्ट यू गाइज टू गो टूडे टॉक टू योर मॉम्स इफ दे आर अराउंड, कि बॉस मैं पैदा कैसे हुआ था, कि क्या मेरी नॉर्मल डिलीवरी थी, कितनी देर मेरी मम्मी लेबर में थी, मैं उनकी हालत उस टाइम क्या थी, कौन से हॉस्पिटल में पहुंची, डिड आई एवर हैव अ कॉर्ड अराउंड माई नेक, वॉज आई अ फोर्सेप डिलीवरी, वॉज आई अ सक्शन पंप बेबी, मैं कैसे पैदा हुआ था, और मैं पैदा होने के बाद बीमार हुआ नहीं हुआ, एनी आइडिया? So something to drool about today. So there's a homework for you guys. Okay. So back home, I want you to do this. Go find out how was your birth. Or classroom mein hum ye aksar paate hain, and it's really interesting that when people have got a cord around their neck. आप imagine करो अगर कोई आपकी गर्दन के इर्द गिर्द ऐसे एक रस्सी बांध दे, क्या महसूस होगा आपको? एक सेकेंड के लिए, जरा एक सेकेंड के लिए ऐसे सोचेंगे कि आपके गर्दन के इर्द गिर्द किसी ने ऐसे रस्सी लेके बांध दी है. आईज बंद करें और मुझे बताएं फीलिंग क्या होती है. चोकिंग और हाँ जी, शहीद भगत सिंह, वेरी गुड. रस्सी बांध दी, बिल्कुल. और कोई फीलिंग हो रही है किसी? हाँ जी, अनइजीनेस, फीलिंग कॉन्ट्रैक्टेड, वेरी गुड. यही फीलिंग जो उस समय रहेगी वो शायद आपकी सारी जिंदगी रहे. हाँ जी, आप सारी जिंदगी फील करेंगे और कहेंगे यार मुझे सफोकेशन होती है, आई एम इन माई ओन हाउस. मम्मी का यूट्रस क्या होता है? इट्स द फर्स्ट होम फॉर मोस्ट ऑफ अस. तो कैसा लगेगा उसको, जैसे कि वो बेबी अपने ही घर में उसकी सांस रुक रही है, उसको शहीद बना दिया गया है, उसको सफोकेशन महसूस हो रही है, अनइजी फील कर रहा है, अपने घर में कॉन्ट्रैक्टेड फील कर रहा है. हाँ जी, बिल्कुल, जैसे कि किसी चीज कोई चोक कर रहा है उसको, और अपने ही लोग उसको चोक कर रहे हैं, और उसे ये समझ नहीं आ रही कि ये फीलिंग कहाँ से आ रही है. अक्सर ऐसी फीलिंग्स बैक टू चाइल्डहुड होती है. अभी 2 मिनट के लिए आप फिर से सोचें कि आपका सर नीचे आ गया है, मॉम के आप डिलीवर होने वाले हैं और बाहर नहीं आ रहे, रेडी नहीं है यार बाहर आने के लिए, और डॉक्टर के मुताबिक आपको पैदा हो जाना चाहिए. तो डॉक्टर क्या कर रहे हैं? फोर्सेप, फोर्सेप का मतलब ऐसे कांटा लेके आपके सिर पे लगते हैं और उसे बाहर निकाल रहे हैं. इतना नहीं खराब होता, द एक्सपर्ट्स, दे नो व्हाट दे आर डूइंग. एंड सक्शन पंप का मतलब, जैसे आपका वैक्यूम सक्शन होता है, सक्शन पंप लगाया सिर पे और बेबी को बाहर निकाला, थ्री इडियट्स में जैसे दिखाया था, ठीक है, बिल्कुल वैसे। सोचिए कि आप इस कमरे में हैं और बाहर कोई ऐसा ही बड़ा वैक्यूम लेके खड़ा है आपको बाहर निकालने के लिए, या फिर आपको कोई फोर्सेप से बाहर निकाल रहा है और आप बिल्कुल रेडी नहीं है ये कमरा छोड़ के जाने के लिए, कैसा लगेगा आपको? हाउ विल यू फील इफ समबडी इज रिमूविंग यू आउट ऑफ योर मदर विद द फोर्सेप और विद सक्शन? आईज बंद करिए, दो मिनट लिए सोचिए कैसा लगेगा। वेरी गुड, इमेजिन ये वाला प्रेशर है सिर पे, ऐसे ऐसे प्रेशर है सिर पे, आपको खींचा जा रहा है जबरदस्ती, हाथों से नहीं ऐसे सर से पकड़ के ऐसे निकाल रहे हैं आपको बाहर, कैसे महसूस होगा?
जैसे कि अभी इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक चल रहा है और इसमें किसी ने मुझे बाहर लेके जाया।
फीलिंग क्या होगी? व्हाट इज द फीलिंग देयर कि जब कोई ऐसे जबरदस्ती आपको निकाल रहा है, फीलिंग क्या होगी? फीलिंग पे जाइए। पार्डन, ड्रैग्ड, वेरी गुड। यू आर गोइंग फ्रॉम कंफर्ट टू डिसकंफर्ट, वेरी गुड। और क्या हो सकता है? ड्रैग्ड। और क्या फीलिंग हो सकती है? फोर्स्ड इवैक्यूएशन, वेरी गुड, लाइक अ रिफ्यूजी, वेरी गुड। और ये एक रीजन हो सकती है कि आपको हर जगह आपको ऐसा लगता है कि मैं रेफ्यूजी हूँ, मुझे फोर्स किया जा रहा है। हाँ जी, आप
घर से कोई निकाल,
हाँ बिल्कुल, अपने घर से आपको कोई निकाल रहा है, आप बेगाने हो गए, आपको कोई ड्रैग करी जा रहा है सारी जिंदगी। तो ये बर्थ का आपको पता करना बहुत जरूरी है। ये पार्ट शेरन किंग पढ़ाती है एंड शी विल बी देयर इन इंडिया नेक्स्ट ईयर इन फेब होपफुली। शेरन किंग, she does about only about births and traumas around the birth, she is the specialist in it, but mera aapko batana zaruri tha ki ye jo hadse hain aapki zindagi mein jiske bare mein aapne kabhi kisi se pucha bhi nahi, iska asar aapki zindagi mein kya ho sakta hai uske bare mein sochna bahut zaruri hai। hum past life mein ghumi ja rahe hain par is zindagi ka before you were born uska aapki duniya pe kya asar hua, आपके आने से पहले माँ बाप एक्चुअली चाहते थे आपको इस दुनिया में लाना? कई बार नॉर्मल डिलीवरी हो रही होती, जैसे मेरी माय डिलीवरी वाज एब्सोल्युटली नॉर्मल, माय मदर एट द टाइम ऑफ डिलीवरिंग मी सेड दिस बेबी इज गिविंग मी सो मच ऑफ पेन, शी सेड दिस लाउडली कि मैं बिचारी हूं, मैं मरने वाली हूं, ये बच्चा मुझे इतनी तकलीफ दे रहा है, मेरे ऊपर इसका क्या असर हुआ होगा? वेरी गुड। और आज तक मुझे ऐसा लगता है मैं किसी को तकलीफ नहीं पहुंचा, सो आई विल मूव अवे फ्रॉम एनी प्लेस वेयर आई फील आई एम मेकिंग पीपल अनकंफर्टेबल, आई विल मेक माई सेल्फ वेरी स्मॉल वेयर आई फील आई एम मेकिंग पीपल अनकंफर्टेबल, and I will wonder whether I should be social with that person or I should not be social with that person. Now bichari actually painful thi uski delivery, okay, but that's how every child comes into this world. Hum kai bar sochte nahi hain fathers ka kitni badi contribution hoti hai, fathers aksar delivery ke time pe bachchon ke paas nahi hote hain, yes, but आजकल हो रहा है and good, I'm happy about it. Yeah, because they know now. At that time, तुम्हारे बच्चा ने आपकी शक्ल देखी नहीं है बॉर्न के बाद, आप काम कर रहे हो, इतने बिजी हो कि आपकी जिंदगी का जो सबसे बढ़िया मेहमान आपकी जिंदगी में आने वाला है उसको देखने के लिए आपके पास वक्त नहीं है, वक्त नहीं है। आप लड़की को देखते हो तो बोलते हो बेटी पैदा होगी, बेटा होता है तो आप बोलते हो अच्छा मिठाई बांटेंगे। ऑल दीज थिंग्स हैव एन इम्पैक्ट ऑन हाउ योर चाइल्ड इज गोइंग टू फील, ओके, सो यू कैन नॉट सब एंड लुक एट इट एंड से ये जरूरी नहीं है। मैंने वही कहा ना, अगर पास्ट लाइफ जरूरी है ना तो ये लाइफ में ये वाले लम्हे बहुत ही जरूरी हैं। और ये तो आप इंटरव्यू कर सकते हो अपनी मदर्स को, पेरेंट्स को, और पता कर सकते हो, जहां पता कर सकते हो, पास्ट लाइफ का तो पता ही नहीं कर सकते। पास्ट लाइफ भी इम्पोर्टेंट है। कई बार जैसे कैरोलाइन ने मेरी मैट्रिक्स रीइम्प्रिंटिंग करी और मुझे पास्ट लाइफ में इतना भरोसा नहीं था, दो आई हैव डन हिप्नोथेरेपी एंड एवरीथिंग, देखी है मैंने पास्ट लाइफ्स, पर अक्सर मैंने लोगों को देखा है पास्ट लाइफ में जाके ट्रॉमा देखते हुए। वी होस्टेड हर, कैरोलाइन हैड कम, कार्ल डॉसन सिस्टर, एंड उन्होंने मेरे ऊपर एक थेरेपी करी थी वेयर आई सॉ माई सेल्फ एज अ जापानीज लेडी इन द प्रीवियस बर्थ एज अ गेशिया। नाउ इट इज सो सरप्राइजिंग, माई ग्रैंड फादर गॉट अ डॉल 2 years before my birth, exactly what I saw in my therapy which she was doing. It's not past life regression, it is past life matrix reimprinting. It's different. These programs are based on images from past events and held in the local fields and regarded subconsciously as current events. जैसे मैंने आपको कहा ना, हुआ कुछ कब, बर्थ के टाइम पे, आज भी हमें याद नहीं है, पर एक सबकॉन्शियस प्रोग्रामिंग, एक बिलीफ, एक मनगढ़ंत झूठ जो हमने अपने आप को बोल दिया है, मेरी मॉम मुझे प्यार नहीं करती, ऐसा नहीं है, पर मैंने अपने आप को बोल दिया कि ओहो मैं उनको अनकंफर्टेबल नहीं कर सकती। एंड इट इज सो फनी, ये अनकॉन्शियस प्रोग्रामिंग आपको बहुत सारी चीजें करने नहीं देगी। There is already something written on the canvas. So, जो आपका स्ट्रेस है, उसके बाद, इसके बाद हम बोलते हैं कि eventually ये जो नेगेटिव प्रोग्राम्स हैं, ये हमारा स्ट्रेस क्रिएट करेंगे और ये स्ट्रेस फिर हमारी डिजीज क्रिएट करेगा। The body will try to adapt. कहाँ कहाँ बॉडी अडेप्ट करेगी? केमिकल लेवल पे, हार्मोनल लेवल पे, सेल्यूलर लेवल पे, डीएनए के लेवल पे, एंड यहां से आपकी साइकोलॉजिकल और फिजिकल प्रॉब्लम्स शुरू होंगी। देखो, पहले दिमाग में चल रही है, आप तब भी उसका कुछ नहीं कर रहे, उसके बाद वो साइकोलॉजिकल और बॉडी के अंदर आएगी, अगर तब भी आप कुछ नहीं करोगे तो फिर आप ऊपर जाने के बाद सोचोगे कि कुछ होगा, कुछ नहीं होने वाला। आपके दिमाग में जो चलता है ना, आपके ग्रैंड चाइल्ड तक जाने वाला है। वही वही कर रही बात। सो देयर आर 3 ways ऑफ डीलिंग विद एनी स्ट्रेस। एक, हम लड़ते हैं अपने आप से या दूसरों से। वी ईदर फाइट विद आवरसेल्फ्स और वी फाइट विद अदर्स। दूसरा तरीका है फ्लाइट, हम या तो भाग जाते हैं या वी आर रनिंग अवे फ्रॉम समथिंग। फ्रीज तीसरा हुआ, बिल्कुल आइस क्यूब की तरह, आप कुछ कर ही नहीं पाए। जो ये कह रही है, सब कहते हैं ऐसे करो वैसे करो, कुछ होता तो है नहीं, ना मैं लड़ सकती हूँ ना मैं भाग सकती हूँ, अभी पति देव से शादी हो गई है, अभी चाहे पति तो चेंज कर सकती हूँ लेकिन पति देव को चेंज नहीं कर सकती। ये भी तो इन्हीं का बिलीफ है। हाँ, अब क्या है ना, ये पति देव को संभाल के बैठेंगी, चाय पत्ती चेंज भी कर लेंगी, लेकिन प्रॉब्लम तो पति के साथ है, जब तक पति को चेंज नहीं करेंगी तब तक प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व नहीं होगी। कोई ये नहीं कह रहा कि आप ऐसे घर में बैठो जहाँ पे पानी गिर रहा है और आप बोलो कि मैं पूजा करता हूँ और ये पानी अपने आप गायब हो जाएगा, होएगा क्या? करके देखिए, बैठो ऐसे, बारिश हो रही है, पानी गिर रहा है, आप खुदा का नाम लें और बोलो पानी, मेडिटेशन करिए उसके नीचे बैठ के, पानी नहीं गिरेगा आपके ऊपर। आप जब तक एक्शन नहीं ना लेंगे तब तक खुदा भी आपकी आके मदद नहीं कर सकता। इसीलिए खुदा ने अपनी तरफ से आपको 2 हाथ दिए, एक भी नहीं, 2 पैर दिए, 2 आंखें दी और 2 कान दिए और मुंह दिया, आपको सब कुछ उसने दिया है खुदा बना के। ही सेड गो डू व्हाट यू वांट टू डू, आई गिव यू फ्री विल अलोंग विद इट, बट वी हैड आवर बिलीव्स एंड वी वर कॉन्स्टेंटली स्पीकिंग लाइज टू आवरसेल्व्स, वी वर कॉन्स्टेंटली बीइंग इनऑथेंटिक टू आवरसेल्व्स, एंड सो हमने ये किया आंखें बंद करके पानी के नीचे बैठे और बोले खुदा तू ही आ जा, हमें क्यों बनाया, आके कुछ तो कर, पानी गिरा, पानी ले जाना, प्लीज पानी स्टॉप कर दे। आप वेट करोगे जिस दिन पानी बंद हो गया तभी बारिश नहीं गिरेगी, नाउ इट इज परफेक्ट, खुदा ने मेरी आखिरी सुन ली, 6 महीने के बाद फिर से बरसाएगा। दिस इज व्हाट वी डू टुडे, ही स्माइल्ड एट मी, सो आज मुझे लगता है कुछ तो मैंने ठीक किया होगा शायद, कल फिर वही बकवास, क्यों नहीं एक्सेप्ट कर लेते कि वो है ही ऐसा डिफेक्टिव पीस, आपने उसको चेंज नहीं करना है, आपने उस घर से बाहर निकलना है जिसकी छत टूटी हुई है या उसकी रिपेयरिंग करानी है, ना आप घर छोड़ने को तैयार हैं, ना आप रूफ ठीक करने को तैयार हैं, फिर क्या करें वो फ्रीज के अंदर। देखिए ना, आपकी जिंदगी की कॉस्ट आपसे कम है। ये देखिए मैंने बिल्कुल सही पहचानी इनकी प्रॉब्लम, वॉट एवर यू सेड इज द प्रॉब्लम अनु। ओके, तो हम लड़ी जा रहे हैं अपने आप से, अपने अंदर ही भागी जा रहे हैं, अपने आप से ही पूछ रहे हैं, एक और थेरेपी सिखाते हैं, शायद समथिंग विल हैपन, बट वी विल नॉट लीव द डिफिकल्ट सिचुएशन एंड मूव ऑन। क्यों क्यों पकड़ के बैठे हो उस फैमिली को जो आपकी कदर नहीं करती, क्यों पकड़ के बैठे हो, आपकी जिद है, क्यों वही चीज, आपकी डाइट भी चेंज कर देते हैं यार, डाइटिशियन के पास जाओ कुछ नहीं खाने को देते, आपको बोलते हैं दूध बंद कर दो, नॉन वेज बंद कर दो, नमकीन बंद कर दो, बोले जीना ही बंद कर देते हैं साहब। सब कुछ ये बंद कर दोगे आप अपने आप पतले हो जाओगे, हाँ आपकी डाइट में से भी वो चीजें निकाल देते हैं, आप उन चीजों को अपनी जिंदगी से नहीं निकालना चाहते जो आपको तकलीफ दे रही हैं। सॉरी, नथिंग कैन बी डन दैट।
पैटर्न बन गया।
वो गाना बोलूं, खुदा के पास जाना है, हाँ। ना हाथी है ना घोड़ा है, वहां पैदल ही जाना है, वहां आप चाहते भी हो ना तो भी कुछ नहीं आने वाला, 60,000 आपके नीचे रह जाएंगे मैडम बैंक में, और कोई और एंजॉय करेगा, सोचो 2 मिनट लिए सोचो, कोई और एंजॉय करेगा उसको, व्हाट विल यू डू, सो व्हाट वी डू इन दिस सिचुएशंस, हम अपने आप को नम कर लेते हैं, वी टेल आवरसेल्फ्स इट इज नॉट हैपनिंग, आंखें बंद कर लेते हैं, हाँ डिनाइंग नहीं, आपका दिमाग आपको भुला देगा, As if it has not happened only. हाँ, आप नम हो जाओगे, आपको कुछ महसूस ही नहीं होगा, क्योंकि आपने अपने आपको कन्विंस कर लिया है इन्हीं हालात में आपने रहना है, उसी वाइफ के साथ रहना है जो हर रोज आपको सड़ा हुआ खाना खिला रही है, आप कुक भी नहीं रखोगे, क्योंकि आपको पैसे कॉस्ट करेंगे, पर जिंदगी कॉस्ट कर रही है उसका आपको तकलीफ नहीं है, यू विल मेक योर सेल्फ नम and you will convince yourself that it never happened. और consciously आप सारी information को सुकार दोगे, every bit of information को आप छोटा कर दोगे, सारी information को आप contract कर दोगे, और आप ऐसे लगोगे, ऐसे थे आप ऐसे लगोगे, आपकी शक्ल पे पता लगेगा दूसरों को कि क्या क्या हो रहा है, पर आपको आपको nothing happened, सगड़ बरं, तुम्ही बरं दिसत नाही, नाही सगड़ बरं, एकदम सब ठीक है, मुझसे मत पूछो, मेरी जिंदगी के बारे में बिल्कुल मत पूछो, बिल्कुल फर्स्ट क्लास चल रही है, यस, दिखाओगे ये फील, ये करो, तो इस समय जब ट्रॉमा होता है उस समय हमारी बॉडी हमारे से कॉन्शियसनेस हमारी स्प्लिट हो जाती है, मतलब ऐसे आपको बोरो कर सकते हो शीतल फिर से, मतलब ये कि इमेजिन करो कि शीतल एक ट्रॉमा के थ्रू गुजर रही है, जो भी ट्रॉमा है. लेट्स से शी इज सिटिंग इन अ कार एंड देयर इज एन एक्सीडेंट एंड एट दैट एक्सीडेंट टाइम शी इज ब्लीडिंग. अब उस समय ना ये लड़ सकती हैं ना ये भाग सकती हैं उस कार में से, उसमें बैठी हैं, कैद हैं कि कोई इनको निकालेगा. हो सकता है उस समय क्योंकि ट्रॉमा इतना ज्यादा है, द ट्रॉमा इज सो मच दैट हर बॉडी हर कॉन्शियसनेस स्प्लिट्स इनटू टू. यस, सो दैट कॉन्शियसनेस विच स्प्लिट्स आउट इज द पार्ट विच विल नॉट लेट यू फील. थैंक यू. सो ऐसे जैसे एक ही इंसान दो पार्ट्स में हो गया, जैसे कि ये दिखा रहे, एंड ये वाला जो पार्ट स्प्लिट हुआ इसके ऊपर हम काम करते हैं. ये जो पार्ट स्प्लिट हुआ इससे हम बोलते हैं एनर्जेटिक कॉन्शियसनेस होलोग्राम, और इसे हम बुलाते हैं एको. सो एको इज नथिंग बट वो एनर्जेटिक पार्ट जो हमी से ऐसे स्प्लिट हो गया है एक ट्रॉमा के समय, और उसकी वजह से हमें हम कुछ महसूस कर नहीं पा रहे हैं, क्योंकि सारा महसूस जो कर रहा है वो एको कर रही
है.
इट इज देयर इन द फील्ड, इट स्प्लिट्स ऑफ एंड इज हेल्ड इन द मैट्रिक्स एंड कंटेन्स ऑल द इंफॉर्मेशन ऑफ द ट्रॉमेटिक इवेंट. मतलब जैसे कि आपने स्टोर रूम अपने साथ कैरी किया है. प्राणिक हीलिंग में आप ये करते हो, ऐसे करते हो, इट्स द सेम थिंग. You're holding information in the field. Yes.
Every cell of the body.
Yes. Not only cell of the body, but in the field, the whole information is held. इसलिए मैंने वक्त लगाया इसको समझाने के लिए. Every person during the trauma will split into two. और क्योंकि आप split हो गए, जो एरिया स्प्लिट हो जाता है जिसे आप देख नहीं पाते हो, वो वहां की उसी एज के ऊपर वहां पे अरेस्ट हो जाता है. वो उम्र में आपकी क्या सोच थी वो वहीं की वहीं अटकन रह जाएगी, और वो सोच को लेके, इंफॉर्मेशन को लेके, बिलीव्स को लेके, डिसीजंस को लेके, वो आपके साथ साथ चलेगा, लेकिन आप बड़े होते जाओगे लेकिन आपकी एको उतनी ही रहेगी. गॉट इट? तो आपकी जो एको है, एको इज द एनर्जेटिक कॉन्शियसनेस होलोग्राम विच इज शॉर्ट फॉर्म और द एनोग्राम इज एको. दिस इज नथिंग बट योर सेल्फ स्प्लिट बैक इन टाइम एंड अरेस्टेड इन टाइम इन दैट एज. और हम सबकी जिंदगी जो अभी चल रही वो है ही नहीं, जब हम काम करना शुरू करते हैं आप पे, हर इंसान की जिंदगी फर्स्ट सिक्स इयर्स में जाके अटक जाती है. वहां पे अगर हम जाके सफाई कर दें तो यहां तक सफाई का प्रॉब्लम होगी नहीं. मतलब कहने का यह है कि अगर मोदी साहब ये कह रहे हैं कि आज सफाई करने की जरूरत है, अगर हम माइंडसेट को उसी दिन पलट देते जब अंग्रेज छोड़ के गए थे हमारे देश को और कहते कि हम सबको सफाई अपने घर की नहीं बाहर भी करनी है, तो आज ये सफाई करने की प्रॉब्लम होती ही नहीं. सेम थिंग, वेरी 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 इंपॉर्टेंट. ये होलोग्राम्स किसी भी उम्र में बन सकता है, ये सिर्फ फर्स्ट सिक्स इयर्स में नहीं बनते हैं. फर्स्ट सिक्स इयर्स इनर चाइल्ड है, उसके बाद बहुत सारे और आपकी एक्वस बनती रहती हैं. मतलब एट एनी एज आप एक इंसान है, लेकिन एक इंसान इज कैरिंग सो मेनी डिफरेंट डायमेंशंस, एंड दिस इज व्हाट यू कैन आल्सो कॉल मल्टीपल पर्सनालिटीज ऑफ योर्स. ओके, अनफॉर्चुनेटली द प्रॉब्लम इज वी सबकॉन्शियसली स्पेंड आवर लाइव्स लिसनिंग टू दीज एकोज एंड ऑफन देयर मिस्टेकन परसेप्शंस. 6 साल की मिस्टेकन परसेप्शंस, जैसे कि मुझे जब मम्मी ने कहा, आई वॉज नॉट इवन बॉर्न एंड वो जोर जोर से चिल्ला रही थी कि मैं मर गई, मुझे इस बच्चे की वजह से बहुत तकलीफ हुई है. आई हैव कैरिड दैट एंड आई एक्चुअली आस्क्ड हर, मॉम ऐसे हुआ था? शी सेड हां हुआ था, बट आई गॉट नथिंग टू डू विद यू. इट हैपेंड बिकॉज आई वॉज जेन्युइनली इन पेन. मैं तो तुझे मिली ही नहीं थी, ऐसे क्या हो, कैसे हो सकता है कि मुझे तू प्यारी नहीं थी. बट आई कैरीड इट इन माई सबकॉन्शियस. अगर मैंने ये प्रोग्रामिंग नहीं करी होती तो मुझे बिल्कुल समझ में नहीं आना था कि उसको साफ कैसे करना है. तो वो वाला प्रोग्रामिंग जो छोटी सी अनु ने किया वो ये था कि आई विल नॉट मेक एनीबडी, अभी भी मैं जब बोलती हूँ इट ब्रिंग्स इमोशंस, आई विल नॉट रिमेन इन एनी प्लेस दैट एनीबडी इज फीलिंग अनकम्फर्टेबल विद मी. मतलब वो मुझे अनकम्फर्टेबल कर रही है, नहीं कि मैं उस जगह पे नहीं रहूंगी जहाँ पे लोग मुझसे अनकम्फर्टेबल हो रहे हैं. मुझे कभी भी लगता है ना तो मैं चुपके से वहां से निकल जाती हूँ. हैव आई वर्कड ऑन इट? यस. इज देयर अ डिफरेंस? आज मुझे जब समझ में आती तो आई विल से दिस इज नॉट द सिचुएशन, दिस इज लिटिल अनु देयर. शांति कर, आस्क द अदर पर्सन आर यू रियली अनकम्फर्टेबल, एंड मोर देन 50% ऑफ द टाइम पीपल से नो वी आर नॉट अनकम्फर्टेबल. Yes. Yes, 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 yes. Even throughout the pregnancy, it's very important what is happening. Everything that is happening in that environment is very, very important. Yes, bilkul. Abhimanyu, you can say about it. Abhimanyu actually knew how to get out of the chakra view. Get in, but didn't know how to get out. She went off to sleep. We have the evidence of this in our epics. तो फर्क यहाँ पे क्या है कि अभिमन्यु को अगर मैं उसके ऊपर matrix imprinting कर रही होती उसकी consciousness पे, तो उसको बोलती, mother को बोलती सो मत, let him find the way out, and फिर उसको बोलती अब तो सो जा, and things would have changed. So you can rewrite your story again. Matrix reimprinting is based on the understanding that when we experience trauma, a part of us splits up, jo maine aapko abhi samjhaya, goes into a hologram matrix, the energetic field that underlines all the existence. These dissociated parts become energy, consciousness, holograms or echoes. This is very clear?
Yes.
Echo creates the effect of amnesia, makes you forget. The event is numbed out from the consciousness as if it never happened, but it lives on in the images of our subconscious and dictates our response of the future situations.
Is it the mind's safety?
Is it the mind's?
Mind's to forget as a safety game, because otherwise if you remember those trauma,
I will work on you and show you. That is what is so interesting, you will remember things that you've never remembered before, and I'm not putting you in any trance. On cellular level, these pictures are real life memories happening right now. They are held for protection, survival and avoidance of similar events. As long as the trauma is held by the echo, similar events will trigger smaller responses. It requires a lot of energy to hold the information, especially when people with lot of trauma who get re-triggered often. एक ही चीज हुई थी लेकिन उसका re-trigger, किसी की शादी नहीं ठीक से चल रही है, wife ने कैसे उससे बात करी, that has got held on. अब कोई और भी उससे ऐसे बात करेगा, he will get triggered back again. When the threshold lowers, disease will result. We need to communicate and talk to these echoes. So matrix reimprinting is a process by which we can talk to these echoes, clean what they, ask them what they want. We get out of the way. We ask what do these echoes want. And wo echo jo bolti hai ki mujhko marna hai usko. Achha, go hit. I want to run away from here. Okay. आज जो प्रोसेस वो उस समय छोटे होते कर रहे नहीं कर पाए हैं वो करने की इजाजत उनको देते हैं. एंड वी ब्रिंग इन अ लॉट ऑफ प्रॉप्स, लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स इन बिटवीन, ताकि वो अपना प्रोसेस करके बाहर निकल सके. व्हेन वी रिलीज द एनर्जी एंड मूव सेफली थ्रू द मेमोरी, द बॉडी सिस्टम कैन लेट गो एंड फील सेफ. So main cheez hai hum insano ke liye safety feel karna. If you are not feeling safe, you have to ask yourself from where is it coming. Addictions khatam ho jati hain in this process. So what I'm going to do now is work on one person, because demonstration is better than anything else. We have 5 minutes, 10, 12, 7, 8. Okay, that's fine. 8 minutes. Who will come here? Who wants to come here and work? No. Come, Sheetal. Today is Sheetal's day. Nene, chair mat lo, aap aajo, 8 minute hai. Kam time hota jayega. Okay, I want you to start tapping with me. Pick up one traumatic event in your life that has happened in your life that you can remember and you want to clean out. Pick up anything that's going on in your life right now.
I had a fall.
Okay, how many days back?
Around 2 weeks back.
Around 2 weeks back, Sheetal had a fall. Okay, what was going on at that time? Where did you get hurt?
On the leg.
Which leg did you get hurt? So she got hurt on the right leg. Are you married? You live with your father?
Mother.
Did anything go along with your mom on that day before you fell down? Did you solve anything? Did you talk to her about anything that you did not like before your fall? Are you working? You're not working. Have a boyfriend? Okay. So let's tap on this. So I have to get a little bit of background. Okay. What is one thing that you really, really want in life and that you're not getting right now? So I got it right that you're living with your mom.
Yeah,
there's no dad.
Yeah,
there's
correct.
No partner.
Yes,
there was
correct.
Never a partner.
Correct.
And you don't have a father at home.
Right.
And both of you are living together.
Correct.
Okay. So let's just tap on mom. 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 All of you do this. Mom. 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 Go to one situation that would be traumatic for you with mom. 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 What's happening? Mom. You pick up one situation with her?
Yeah, no.
Okay, pick up one. Huh. I'll hold her hand at the stage and I'm tapping on her. Pick up mom.
Yeah.
Okay, one thing that's happening with mom?
She's into a lot of stress. And
give me one scene. Pick up one scene where you can see everything and there's something happening between you and mom. 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 What's happening?
Basically, she doesn't agree to whatever.
She doesn't agree to you?
Yeah.
Okay, so pick up one scene like that. That's her belief. Okay? My mummy doesn't listen to me.
Yeah.
Okay. So let's.
I
always listen to her and do what she is telling. Very good. My mom doesn't listen to me. Doesn't listen to me.
Yeah.
So stay with me.
My mom doesn't listen to me.
Go to one scene, Sheetal. Fine tune to one scene where your mom is not listening to you.
Like I told her to.
How long back is that scene?
4-5 days
back. Okay, so what's happening 4-5 days back?
So I had told her to, long to go.
Okay.
So she
sure told you to lock the door. You told her to lock
yeah,
the door.
She did not.
So can you see that scene?
Yeah.
Okay, can you close your eyes please? Can you see Sheetal who's 3 or 4 days younger than you?
Yes.
You can see her? Very good. What is she wearing?
I'm wearing a pink t-shirt.
Okay. Can we stop addressing her as you and say she's wearing?
Okay.
Yeah, because she's 3-4 days younger than her. She's wearing pink color t-shirt and what else is she wearing? She's wearing tights. Very good. So you can see where the scene is happening?
Yeah, in my house.
In your house, okay. So I just want you to walk into that scene. Just remember you're older than her. I just want you to go over there. Hold her hand like I'm holding yours. I'm your therapist and I want you to understand that you are her therapist. I cannot see her. You will go in over there. Say hi to her, tell her that you're coming from her future. You have to introduce yourself. Very good. And can you just hold her hand like I'm holding yours? Okay. Can you tap on her like I'm tapping on you? She allow you to tap on her? Okay. Just tell her it's a nice tapping technique. She doesn't let you tap on her field. Just tap on her field. Ask her how she's feeling when she sees the door open and she realizes mom has not taken her instructions, not listened to her. What's happening with her? Feeling not good.
Yeah.
Feeling not good. Okay. So little Sheetal, younger Sheetal by 3 days is not feeling good because mom is not listening. Just check if anything else is coming up. You will take yourself out of the place and listen to her. Don't talk on her behalf. Keep tapping on her and ask her how she is feeling. Kaise mehsoos kar rahi hai wo? So how is she feeling? She's feeling better because she's tapping already, okay? I want you to tell her to hold her hand and tell her to take you to another incident back in time where she was feeling bad like this because mom did not listen to her. You'll be able to move now. Just move with her. Any other scene coming up? Go to another scene where mom is not listening to her. Back in time when she was much younger.
Okay.
How old are you there?
So
2-3 months back, mama is not listening. She is having a whole brick of ice cream. How is Sheetal feeling over there? Keep tapping on her. You know how to do it. Get into the scene. So that's a decision she made. My mom is very stubborn. Yes. And she's still feeling bad, or is there anything else going on there?
So, I was feeling very, that time, very sad for her that, she's ruining her own health.
Right. She's feeling sad for her, she's feeling that
pity,
mom is very pity for her. Okay. Go along with this feeling. Go hold your echo's hand and go back in childhood and see where is it that little Sheetal has made her decided that mom is very stubborn, she is feeling pity for her mom, she is feeling like a bad girl herself and not feeling good about things.